continuar a apresentar a minha conversa com o George Pimentel, que foi extremamente agradável de nos receber naquela galeria enorme que foi posta só mesmo para as suas fotografias na Yorkdale. How long is it going to be on?
Well, the best thing about this is that Yorkdale Shopping Center is going to have this till September 30th. And it's amazing the traffic that has come down. It's amazing that we had an opening and my father showed up and I brought him on the stage. And in the end, it was just nice to honor him, and he's still alive, and I'm glad that he saw this.
That's fantastic.
A proud father to see his son.
This is why you're in the Portuguese Walk of Fame as well. It's not so much for what you have done, it's for what you're still doing and continue to do. George, how many of the film festivals have you participated in, where?
I've been covering, my baby is the Toronto Film Festival. So
I started with TIFF,
and it by far is the best film festival because it has the most movies.
So, but you've gone to Venice Film Festival, Cannes, which
from, kind of from, okay, from the Cannes Film Festival, from Venice Film Festival, Sundance Film Festival.
Oh, yes.
You know, and of course we come back to Toronto, it's like, you know, believe me, that keeps me busy enough. But then January starts with all the award seasons. I do the Golden Globes, I do the SAG Awards, and I'm very fortunate right now is that now in my, I'm 56 years old. But where my career has changed is that I don't necessarily go on the red carpets with all the photographers anymore. I roam the carpet now. I work in hand with the celebrities. The other night I was with Mark Wahlberg and he was promoting a vodka line. I'm with him. And so that's what I want to do. I'm too old to be with 300 photographers screaming to get the photo. I mean, when I look at these photos, it makes me nervous because that's not who I am anymore. I'm privileged to roam the carpet and get the candid moments.
Well, you're like this young man and young lady.
Well, this is young Hollywood, young love.
2011.
Okay? Yeah, and this is like innocence. Like, look at their faces.
Yes.
And they're in love. Like, they're in love. This is first love.
Yes.
You know, and
yes.
It's funny when you see Bieber now, he's a grown man. He's like, you know, he's not clean like this anymore, right?
No.
You know?
No, that, and then you have Harry Styles.
And then you have, like, you know,
the top, One
Direction
right
star,
now.
Like, doing a movie, and the fans, they just, like, the young kids, they love him, and he's just talented, and when you hear him sing, he's amazing, so, you
Is
know.
There the stars that call out George's name?
Sometimes.
Yes.
Sometimes.
Like who?
Sometimes. A lot of Canadian stars, they all know me.
Right.
And they will hug me and shake. And I've had Brad.
Like the neighbor.
I've had Lady Gaga. I've had her.
Wow.
Tell the security, come on over.
I got it. Yeah, I saw this photo of her here.
So this is my prize, best red carpet.
Yeah.
Where
you can see
I'm on the carpet. I'm with her. I'm working with her. But she actually told the security in her car as she's on the way, stay out of my way.
Really?
Let George do his thing.
Wow.
And so me and her were all over the carpet. I was shooting her with the fans, and she asked me, she whispered in my ear, when should I take off my veil? And I said, give it a couple of minutes. We worked it, and then she walked down the carpet, and she slowly lifted her veil, and the fans went nuts, and I got to take the photos, and this is the moment. And everybody will remember the premiere of A Star Is Born with Bradley Cooper, and this is the moment, Toronto Film Festival moment, when Lady Gaga lifted her veil. It was a big deal.
And she did it for you. Although
she did it for someone, but I got the shot. I got the shot.
You got the shot.
But then,
wonderful.
But then, look at it. But then, I'm going to show you. Like, if you're watching if you're watching like White Lotus.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, if you're watching White Lotus, like, you know, Jennifer Coolidge, like it took her like 25 years to finally get her award and finally get her spotlight because she says to herself that she was kind of a B-list actress and, you know, she just kept working and working.
Right.
And this is a, you know, now like everybody loves Jennifer Coolidge and I got her. I got her backstage at the SAG Awards and she just went to present. You can see like it's backstage at an auditorium.
Right.
And I was lucky to be there and to capture the shot.
Wow. George, from Yorkdale, what's next for George Pimentel?
I'm going to sleep. Estou cansado, mas dorme.
Dormir pouco. Depois do film festival.
No, you know, you know, it's funny. I just did a project on my grandfather. So I went back and I printed my grandfather's work and I showed it back with my pictures of Rob Page. Back and I remember you covered that like
years ago.
Yeah, it was 1992, and you covered that. You were there.
Uh-huh.
I came out of school, but I blew the dust off the photos. And I printed, so that was, it just finished, and I'm gonna be putting that at my studio.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the complete opposite of this type of work. But for me, I'm just a normal guy. I go to Costco and I shop for socks. I'm just a peach, okay? And I go to Dundas and I can still, I have the Velioch. The Velioch is coming in for passport photos. They recognize me and they tell me old stories.
That's
and
fantastic.
You know what? It keeps me, Dundas West and that area is like home for me.
Yes.
It keeps me grounded and it's important for me to just be real and honest.
Well, I think that the celebrities that you photograph realize that you are very real, very honest, and very professional
with
what you do. And that's why they adore you as well.
Thank you.
And don't mind posing for you. George, do you recommend this as a career for younger men, young boys, young women, in terms of being a photographer for celebrities?
The world is changing. I'm just, whatever career you're doing, my advice to the young kids out there, do what I did. I never waited by the phone. I never waited for a phone call. I even talked to actors about this. You can't wait by a phone call to get a movie role. You have to go get it. You have to go outside and hustle and meet people and collaborate with the right people to figure out what you want to do. But you can't wait by the phone. Never wait. Go after it.
Let me ask you one more question. How has technology changed your art?
Well, it's amazing because everyone's a photographer now.
Exactly.
And when I do events, everyone hands me their cell phone and to take their photo, and they don't care. And they just want a memory.
Right.
So there's more images than ever because of the cell phone, and now with AI, it's gonna explode. But the art, you know, it's all about the focus and art and crafting. And it's not everybody does photographic prints. And it's nice to see photographic prints. It's a different feeling. And I think this will always stay.
Absolutely. Well, good luck, and thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just amazing. No dia em que falei com o Jorge, também foi a abertura do Toronto Film Festival, uma das funções mais importantes aqui em Toronto para os filmes, e é uma das coisas que o Jorge fazia e faz várias vezes, é de ir filmar os artistas, a sua chegada, as suas festas que eles têm tido para ir fotografá-los, para depois então as diferentes revistas através de todo o mundo poderem as expor. Obrigada ao Jorge e parabéns ao Jorge. Esta exposição está ainda na Yorkdale até o fim do mês de setembro. Agora, a parte final do programa de hoje.
Já estou a servir a comunidade portuguesa há mais de 50 anos em todo o aspecto de seguros.
Para seguro de carro, casa ou comercial, confia em Vieira & Associates.
I just started my training and I am Liuna.
Está pensando em mudar a aparência da sua casa? Precisa de novas janelas?
Se necessita portas ou janelas, não hesite. Contate-nos.
Ligue para Bayview Windows and Doors hoje mesmo.
Estamos a terminar a programação de Gente da Nossa com o programa Bom Dia. O nosso programa iniciou às 8 horas da manhã aqui na TLN e vai continuar a estar aqui na TLN para sempre. Por que não? Porque nós gostamos de aqui estar. Só mais uma vez convido os amigos a divulgarem onde nós estamos, onde nos podem encontrar no nosso novo lar aqui na TLN. Foi um prazer estar convosco para apresentar o programa de hoje. Vamos voltar já para a semana com outro programa diretamente aqui da TLN, das 8 até às 9h30. Assim como também podem ver este e outros programas visitando o nosso portal da gentetv.com e também o nosso canal do YouTube. Foi um prazer estar convosco. Um beijinho a todos. Bye bye. Até para a semana.